I don't think anybody saw Pavelski get three stocks over Viper here. So let's get into the game. Our next match coming up is it's a good one here. It's winner's final, you know it. Akno versus Pavelski. We've been waiting for this matchup all day.
Whoa, we don't have to wait much longer. They're already getting into it here. Okay, nice. Pavelski on the Lucian. We've been liking this pick. His guitars, his blasts, we're looking clean all day. And Akno on that Koji. Koji, such a favored legend this tournament in both North America and EU, it seems.
Oh, I'm so glad Pavelski's back on the Lucian here. He was playing some Onyx earlier today, and I was like, all right, Pavelski, that's cool. That's cool.
Quit fooling around.
But yeah. He's back on the Lucian now. This is going to be great. Going up against Akno. Man, you know, the last time we saw these two fight, I think it was you and me casting it together, actually.
Yes.
It was so close. Pavelski was so close. Yeah, took it to game five, man.
And it was
the wire.
And it was a taunt to get bodied, I think, wasn't it?
It was. Pavelski had thought he won. He taunted it up a little too early. Akno came back and scored the W. It was hard to see. And Pavelski, you know, he's after justice here. He needs revenge. What do you think, revenge or justice?
What's the difference, right? You know? What's the difference to a gunslinger like Pavelski out here? But man, he's going to have to do some work if he wants to come back. Akno already looking like he could take out this first stock. Wait, okay, Pavelski had a little bit of opportunity there, but taken out the top by the recovery.
That's a pretty early stock. This is not looking good for
Pavelski. Honestly, he beat the spread, though. If you look at Akno's first stock on people,
yeah,
making it over a minute.
Average damage on first stock is...
This
is good for the average.
Yeah, he gets like 30-second stocks. So putting him over a minute is definitely changing the pace for him.
There's a different scale for Akno.
Yeah, and now we see Pavelski with the guitars in hand. The weapon he throws those away. Favoring the blasters, maybe he likes the kill opportunity there.
Not far up enough. You know, Lucian's got very little strength. I think three? He only has three strength.
Yeah, so not a lot of strength.
The recoveries are going to do that. Now, if you use the signatures, you know.
And that's what he's looking for here. You see him fishing. He goes for the down, goes for the neutral. Akno has those gravity cancel down lights. Oh, Akno, whoa.
Ooh, you see Akno just waiting after he started babysitting him, hoping that Pavelski would dodge. I think Pavelski was well aware and didn't give him that dodge he was looking for.
Oh, my God.
You see how he held on to a little bit of that side sig? And still made it a true combo. That was still true.
Right.
But he did get just a little bit more charge than you normally would have using that Koji side sig. Oh, good. You see him cancel, ledge cancel just to get that little extra neutral light? Ooh. My goodness. Okay. Pavelski takes the stock, but Akno's already taken my heart here.
Dude, but I like the white outlook that Pavelski's got. He's got the white color swap.
That's classic.
He's got the snow KO effect. He's got the look set up. It's like dark versus light here. Jedi versus Sith. Oh my gosh, but the Sith is strong with Akno.
Yeah. This isn't looking good for Pavelski. I have to be honest with myself. You do have to be honest with yourself sometimes, especially in battle.
I
want to see Pavelski take this, to be honest. But Akno is just too solid right now. With this big of a lead, it'd be difficult for him to drop it at this point. Sword recovery nearly gets the job done. I don't think Pavelski can live through another one of those.
Oh, Akno's looking for his dodge.
There it is.
Yeah, as soon as he did that gravity cancel, he was without his dodge, and he was just food for Akno to clean up that game. Man, game one.
You know, interesting. A lot of countries, a lot of nations compete in the European tournaments, right? It's a very wide region with a lot of countries inside it. But how appropriate is it here that the two players that have the only two players in this tournament that haven't lost yet are both from Bulgaria?
Dude, there's something in the water in Bulgaria. Yeah. Man. I'm thinking about moving. Let's go. If it makes me better at Brawlhalla, I will change my address for sure. Okay. But speaking of changes, Pavelski going with a Hattori pick now. The sword ditto, grabbing the spear as well.
I don't know how I feel about this, dude. I mean, I thought maybe Onyx. He's been doing a lot of Onyx. This Hattori seems a bit out of left field. It's almost like he's just trying to throw Akno off. He's like, have you even fought my Hattori before?
Yeah. You know? The thing, though, Akno is such a fast player. Like, you can see how efficient somebody is with their movement. They tend to just whip around the screen a bit quicker. And I think maybe just boosting that speed stat might help get on top of the way Akno's playing.
Sure, yeah, that's a good point. And Pavelski's definitely one to be able to utilize the speed well. He is talking about fast players. Pavelski's all over the place.
All right, a better start for Pavelski so far. Damage is pretty much even. He's a little bit ahead. He's pressuring Akno off the side. Akno fighting his way back up through.
This sword ditto, man, we were talking about it before. Akno's, I think it wouldn't be a stretch to say that Akno is the best sword player in Europe.
Yeah, I mean, he's clearly the best player in Europe, and he's often playing sword, so I don't know who would dispute that. But, oh, okay. All right, loses his spear, going to pick up that weapon. Akno now searching for a weapon on the field. Pavelski going to go hunt, or, you know, he's hold it down there. Akno able to pick up that bow. Was looking for, oh my gosh, way to burn that corner. Can he get this edge guard? Akno making it back to the wall, gets a touch safely. The ground pound just barely missing outside.
Oh, what a perfect signal! Oh, that was such an excellent counter.
I blinked. Did he do the gravity? Did he gravity cancel the down?
Exactly. Oh, and the built-in feint from the down sig avoided Akno's down sig and then came back in for the KO. It was so perfect. An excellent decision. And that was a read. That could not have been a reaction.
Right.
It all happened at the same time. Anyway, kind of doesn't matter as Akno equalizes the stocks without taking a tiny bit of damage. He didn't get hit once before he took that stock back. Akno. Can anybody defeat Akno?
I mean,
this man has won every single tournament in Europe in 2020. This would be the first tournament he lost if Pavelski could somehow take him out.
Man, Pavelski was on top of that edge guard, but Akno just would not stop fighting his way up through, gets back to the top of the stage, now armed up with that sword again. A little bit behind in damage. Pavelski with a bit of a lead, needs to push it. Okay, pushes it a bit further there. Akno now off on the corner, gives him some space to get back up. Oh, the shutdown.
Yeah, Pavelski was really going. Okay, punish the side. This is it.
Yes!
What a play
that
from
was
Pavelski.
So good. Man, the gravity cancel down light on Spear is such a good option in the air. Just to get that, you know, that diagonal coverage that you really don't have with Spear in the air.
Yeah.
And to confirm the KO. Now, again, a little bit of a lead. Has to push it here. Akno
got to push it. Oh, that was... Whoa, was that a weapon throw? Fastball, re-grab into a recovery, true combo? Pavelski's so fast.
I'm already seeing a change in this character pick. I like this pick from
the speed is working out for him. You were right about that.
Yeah. And when you lose in defense, the survivability make up the movement off stage, you know?
What?
Oh! Okay.
Alright, hey, that's a pretty good amount of damage lead to have against Akno on the last stock.
Is it though? I mean, honestly, I feel like if Akno was in red, I wouldn't feel safe.
Well, you wouldn't feel safe.
Yeah, double down when he comes through with another recovery. Akno's in red, but don't feel safe,
You can't feel safe. He's got to
get another recovery. Oh, he gets it again! What? Oh my god.
That was a clear stock, too. He didn't get touched on that last stock. Pavelski answering back, tying up the set 1-1.
Wow.
It's going to be good.
We're going to try and look at some of these replays here, but they are getting right
They're already loading in.
Yeah.
We'll get this one. Check this out. It's the last hit, too. This is perfect. He catches them with that down light. Oh, and then true combos into the recovery. There's nothing he can do.
Yeah, that was incredible. He did that. Yeah, he did that. Gravity canceled that down light so soon. He knew exactly where Akno was going to go. Amazing there for both of them. Pavelski now 1-1 in the set. Gets them. And we're sticking with Miami Dome. I like that.
Same map, same characters. Akno is willing to just run it back. Got to be matched with the confidence to lose on stage. Then have the opportunity to ban it out, but you just keep it there anyway.
Right.
Inviting your opponent to pick the same map they just beat you on. That is the level of confidence that we see only in Akno and, like, Noel.
Right, exactly. and especially the way Belts was playing with those, threatening the air with those downlights and gravity canceled downlights. I don't know if I'd want these tall, soft platforms hanging up here, separating the space like that, but Akno knows what he's doing. He picked up that stock to lead here in game 3. And
Akno,
what weapons are you come away with?
He's probably welcome to the challenge, man. He's into it. Like, how close can we make this game?
You know, there's something to be said about, okay.
With the sidelight reset, true combo, and a piece. Let's keep it going. Ooh. Oh, look at that. He got outside of the weapon throw and hit him with the neutral light. This guy's a master of his hitboxes.
Okay. All right, let's get dodge. Gets in the weapon throw.
God, what else do you have? Pavelski's in trouble now. He can just die with this.
What? Ow.
Oh, lucky to be alive. Pavelski off stage again.
Oh, man.
Fights his way back up. Akno.
He really wants that side signature to finish this stock.
Okay. Oh, that was a great time to ground pound.
Oh, my gosh. He's taking so much damage for all those side signatures trying to get off, but pay off.
He's
for him
a
here.
Whole stock ahead
he
still.
Is
Did
true.
We forget that Akno has died? He still hasn't lost.
All right. It's got to be impossible for Echo to come away with three stock, but I'm ready to see it. Let's go.
Let's see. All right. We're talking about time.
Ooh, that's the way to do it.
Oh, that's it. There's no way.
Oh, yeah.
Light kick ground pound on arm, off stage.
I know. You're basically just booing any of these players that slide kick ground pound.
Yeah. I mean, these top players, they get their opponent into like a checkmate situation, which they, I know you have to come to this very spot right now. There's nothing else you can do and you'll die. And so,
you know, I'm
slide kick ground
pound. I think I'll make this happen. What actually likes to stop that. Wall and he can't pass. It makes every edge guard opportunity.
Oh, yeah, he is. He's probably the best. At the best. So, that does kind of help amplify his pressure. So,
and there's nowhere he can go. It's now game three. Now Akno ahead in the set. 2-1. Belt can turn this around because he knows the character pick.
He does have the same character. No swaps here.
Oh, yeah.
But Pavelski's going to have to win twice in a row to get a victory in this match. Otherwise, he's going down to the lower final to face the winner of Simple versus Machete.
Right. Important to point out, yeah, that everyone here hasn't lost yet. They still got some life
left. These guys are guaranteed top three. They are already on the podium.
Now we're going to Deep Island. Talk about edge opportunity. That's slim ball, dude. And there's not much to cling to.
You know, I would say we always talk about like what the entirety of that ball. And I don't think either of these guys have like the mid.
Almost.
Oh,
gets around it.
Dive picking underneath the weapon throw.
Oh man, that nair actually saved his life.
Damage here. 30 seconds.
He can't even make
it
back to the ground.
What's he gonna do?
Okay.
Akko had he had the counter ready.
Really
stock.
If you see someone take a game off Akko, it's usually like the first game, second game. He seems to snowball. Once he gets he doesn't lose that confidence, which is so key.
Yeah. Yeah, he plays well with Magenta. But he also plays well on a comeback. Like no big deal for Akko. His head's not leaving the game.
Okay,
Pites back to stage. Nice weapon throw, stopping Akno from pressuring him. One weapon on the field, and Pavelski takes it. Akno doesn't care, going in unarmed. Doesn't need a weapon. Not the weapon throw, and Pavelski doesn't have anything. Oh, man, it just keeps getting worse. Pavelski, what's he going to do now? He's got
I think he got smashed into the stage. He bounced off there with that down air. Still holding for the second stock.
He's really outplaying him here. This is hard to watch, dude.
Dude, it's not hard to watch.
You're right.
You got to hook up that clockwork orange thing. Like... No, look at this. Look at this, Oda. Okay, wait a second. The blight here in Pavelski coming back on this last stock. He is behind a whole stock against Pack. This region has been his opinion. But maybe Pavelski knows.
Okay.
Right there.
A zero to death here would be just great.
Hey, wouldn't that be awesome?
It would. Pavelski, he loves zero to death. He kind of eats some breakfast. What a big tackle. What
a great
bad
comeback.
Man. Who would ever do that? And who would ever expect that? Except
Akno. Yeah.
Completely expected it. Nice! Oh, Pavelski thought he might have comboed the recovery off of that. Now he's got to end this stock now. But he catches him on the rebound. Okay.
Just a distraction thing. Sometimes
distraction
you got to do those. So now it's just one stock to each of them. Elf go behind the dame, looking to make it up here. Actually, with a thought, that double down light, picking up the bow, and already dealing out some damage as Pavelski in the red in his final stock. All right, Akno doesn't need much to close this game out, but, you know, for another weapon. Oh, good. Double neutral light. All right, put pressure across the game. Akno, is that a really shot? No, not quite yet, but he cannot survive another. Akno, only one big hit. The dots there. Good combo. Oh, and the weapon throw. Keep it going. What? Pavelski on this final stop.
Movement.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, Pavelski, honestly, doing well from behind, but Akno.
Pavelski got to take in that game, but that's it. The match is over. Akno moves on to grand finals as expected. It's a guaranteed top two. And now we're going to have some bouts just to figure out who is worthy of fighting Akno in grand finals.
Yeah.
Guys, we're going to take a super quick 1-minute break. Don't go anywhere. We're going to be right back in just a moment.